I thought when I saw the Prime Minister's press conference earlier this week, he started so well. He actually sounded like he'd finally got it. He was repeating back to us as we were listening the things that he'd heard from women. I don't know, in his family, in his office, in his social networks, the frustrations that so many women feel. And then 10 minutes into the press conference, because he gets a question from a journalist, he just loses it again and makes us think, was it all an act? Were the tears all an act? Can I tell you, Mr. Deputy Speaker, the tragedy for Australian women today is if we started crying about the women we know who have been raped and murdered and sexually assaulted and sexually harassed, if we started crying for the women that we know that this had happened to, we would never stop. We would never stop. Because I remember the names of Anita Cobby and Janine Balding, the women who were abducted and raped and tortured and murdered when I was growing up. I remember their names. They have always stayed with me. And I remember Eurydice Dixon, and I remember Hannah Clark. I remember all of these women. We all do. It takes more than tears. It takes legislative change. It takes culture change. It takes working with our young people from their earliest days. Why is sexual violence one of the few categories of violent crime that's actually increasing in our community, despite everything we know, despite the truth that brave women like Grace Tame and Brittany Higgins and Chanel Contos and Saxon Mullen, despite the fact that these young women are getting up and telling their truth in their own words, actually sexual violence is one of the violent crime categories that's increasing, and it's increasing particularly amongst young people. Mm. We have failed as a parliament and as a community when we see increasing rates of sexual assault